there are 47% of the people who vote for the president no matter what. All right, there are 47% who are with him, who are dependent upon government, who believe that they are victims, who believe that government has a responsibility to care for them, who believe that they're entitled to health care, to food, to housing, to you name it. But that's an entitlement, and the government should give it to them. And they will vote for this president no matter what. And I mean, the president starts off with 48, 49, 43. He starts off with a huge number. These are people who pay no income tax. 47% of Americans pay no income tax. So our message of low taxes doesn't connect. And he'll be out there talking about tax cuts for the rich. I mean, that's what they sell every 4 years. And so my job is not to worry about those people. I'll never convince them. They should take personal responsibility and care for their lives. What I have to do is convince the 5 to 10% in the center that are independent, that are thoughtful, and looking for it one way or the other, depending upon them.
That's really rare. If it's a legitimate rape, the female body has ways to try to shut that whole thing down.
I'm not sure if men really understand this, but I don't think there's a woman in America who really expects her life to be easy.
With the full backing of Iran and Hezbollah and Russia, with tanks and helicopters and fighter jets, murdering men, women, and children. More than 20,000 people have perished. People are seizing control of their own destiny. With the full backing of Iran, Hezbollah, and Russia, they want with tanks and helicopters and fighter jets, with the full backing
as they struggle to live in
Hezbollah and Russia
to expand opportunity for themselves and their fighter jets,
with the full backing of Iran, Hezbollah, and Russia, with tanks and helicopters and fighter jets,
America.
Change in leadership. Why would the next 4 years be any different from the last 4 years? Childhood bedrooms, staring up at fading Obama posters. That's the American dream. Supervision and sanctimony of the central planners. We're a full generation apart. Governor Romney and I.
And in some ways we're different. There are the songs in his iPod, which I've heard on the campaign bus. We are going to solve this nation's I hope it's not a deal breaker, Mitt. My playlist, it starts with AC/DC and it ends with Zeppelin. How much time? We can do this.
To get a constitutional amendment, a marriage between one man and one woman.
He's going to vote for a baby killer and a homosexual lover.
Get 3/4 of the states to ratify it, and that way it would take care of that problem. Again, why am I running? Why have I been in this race for 2 years? When Senator Snow had an opportunity to vote one man and one woman as a constitutional amendment, she voted undecided. These are the reasons I'm getting into this race. This is the reason I've been fighting for. Look, I also want you to know the senator that you send to D.C. will be the one that sits face to face with the next Supreme Court justice. And in the next 4 years, that decision is going to be one of the most important decisions facing this country. If we get a Supreme Court justice along the lines of Sonia Sotomayor and Elena Kagan, and we get time, it doesn't matter what these people want. They're going to push through their agendas like they already are now. They're legislating from the bench. And our senator, both our senators, support Elena Kagan and Sotomayor. And Snow also supported Ruth Gensheimer. So I can't stress how important that is as your senator to follow the Constitution, install legislation from the bench, and getting these judges to follow the Constitution. Thank you.
I think I also have respect for the law, and I particularly respect the law that is passed by the people of Maine. There have been several votes on this issue here in Maine, and people of Maine decided that marriage should be defined, as I suggested, between one man and one woman. And we need to uphold that, respect it. In my view, as an elected public official, I'm always troubled by the efforts from the legislature, from the executive branch, from the court, in undoing the express vote of the people. I think it's fundamental to our democracy, and fundamental to respect who's really in charge of our democracy, and to respect the will of the people. And particularly when it's expressed in public referendum, it's no clearer. But there's always efforts to erode and change the law because, you know, the administration doesn't like it, so he appoints people that are going to interpret a certain way, or make some executive order or a signing statement, which thwarts the will of the law, the appropriate lawmaking authority, whether it's the people or the legislature, the Congress, and I think it needs to stop. And fundamental to me in my public record is respect for the will of the people.
Traditional marriage Catholic. That's what I believe. I also believe in the Constitution. And I also realize that the root of many of our problems is that our federal government is too big, it's too expensive, and it's too intrusive. The states of Congress determine the definition of marriage. We have done that several times, as was just mentioned here, in the state of Maine. If I have the opportunity to serve as the next United States Senator, I will believe what I believe in, which I just told you, but I will also uphold the Constitution. I do not believe the federal government should be involved in defining marriage. That should be something reserved for the states, which in my mind is very clear in the 10th Amendment.
We have a problem.